and you breathe one word of this, just one, I'm going to make you wish you were dead. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Now get in there.
An album, Jude. And Dave and Gary and everyone, well, they want you to do all the material for it. And I do too, Jude. Look, it's not because I think I owe you or anything like that. It's just that I reckon between the two of us, we could come up with the biggest selling album this country's ever seen. Well, what do you reckon?
Carrying on like this is not going to help. Okay, so your mum couldn't get a bigger size in that style.
Style be buggered. She couldn't get a bigger size in any style.
Well, she hasn't given up, has she?
She might as well have shop shut in an hour.
It's amazing what you can do in an hour.
Okay, now what?
We're not going to waste time nursing her back to health, are we? You look after Jasmine. I'll look after this bastard for the last time.
Jeff!
Bastard!
Get out! That was for Pixie, for Jan, and for Anita, you bastard!
Oh, Jeff! Lou said a lot of other stuff too, rotten bitch. About how the Pope and his mates just sitting there fat bums smothered in jewels while the poor people are made to have more and more kids.
And you want to know if it's true?
Yeah.
Well, I can't tell you it's a lie. But it's all a matter of perspective. Oh, the church pays lip service to contraception, but it's not really very effective. As for the cardinals, well, they'd make your boy George look positively dowdy by comparison.
But how can they do that when people are starving?
I'm not saying it's right. I've questioned it many times myself. Most Catholics just accept that that's the way it is.
Oh, yeah, well, I reckon it stinks. I'm sorry.
Oh, don't be sorry. Questioning's the only way of really knowing if your faith will stand the test. The church makes mistakes, Lexi, but the mistakes are made by people, not God.
But they're still mistakes, aren't they?
Yes, but the word of God, of Jesus Christ, that's constant. The word is perfect, even though the church isn't. And if you want to be a Catholic, you have to accept that, warts and all.
Well, there are enough warts in the world already. I want it, I don't know, just something in my life to be really good.
Well, Lexi, the goodness in life, that comes from within. And if you can't accept the church, all of it, that doesn't mean there's no purpose to your life. Just be a good person. That's all God asks. Some of the best Christians I've known have claimed to be agnostics, yet they lived their lives the way Jesus intended, full of love and compassion for their fellow man, never hurting anyone.
That's all it takes, eh?
Yep. So stop expecting more of yourself than God does, okay?
Okay. But aren't you mad at me? I mean, if I'm not going to be a Catholic, I've just wasted your time.
I could never be mad.
Oh, real touching. Sorry to break up the romance.
Oh, God, you're hurt.
Get out, will you?
Just what happened?
Do as she says, love. We'll talk later. Dear, let me help you.
I've told you before, stay in your own space. You wreck off and leave me alone.
Thought I told you to keep out.
Now, come on, that's what friends are for. Don't give me any lectures.
Are you okay, Maya?
I'm fine, love. I'm in better shape than you. Just save your breath.
Just what the hell's going on here?
Please, Mr. Cruikshank, not now. We've got to get him to the infirmary.
Oh, that'll be Burke. He needs help too.
All right, get along to the security gate. Somebody will take you to the hospital. But this isn't the end of it. There'll be questions asked, I can tell you.
What the hell are you going to come up with for answers?
Oh. Here, let me help you.
I told you to wreck off!
Lou, I don't take orders from you. I thought you knew that by now.
But don't need any help.
Everybody needs help sometime in their life. Now, just be quiet and let me do this.
I don't need any friend of Desmond's.
What's Myra got to do with anything?
Who do you think did this to me? Oh, yeah, the weasel started it, but she finished it. Your precious mate, Desmond.
You make it sound like I'm the enemy just because Myra's my friend.
You got it in one.
It's not true, you know. I'd be your friend, too, if you'd let me.
Oh, yeah, I bet. You don't know why she bashed me.
It doesn't matter. It must matter. I'd never turn my back on you.
You're a bigger fool than I thought.
Maybe, but I don't think so.
Let me be, will you?
No way.
I don't need any... I don't need anyone. Not you, not anyone. Leave me alone.
Anything?
Nobody knows what happened.
Surprise, surprise.
A bit queer it being in the library, though. I mean, that's where Joan got thumped.
You think Burke's behind both bashings?
Well, if Desmond didn't bash Joan...
then Burke's next on the list. All right, let's try and get some answers. I want to know how this happened and who started it. If I don't get answers, all of you will go to solitary, Desmond included.
Give it a rest, lady. I won't even make it to solitary if someone doesn't fix me up.
All right, Burke, let's have a look at you.
About time.
Craig?
Sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, I don't know anything about it.
Take it easy!
Desmond? Well, fortunately, it missed her weak spot. She'll be okay. Bruises, contusions, but she's very lucky. These two? Hell, they'll make it.
I can tell you're real happy about that, sister.
Just keep it shut.
How are you feeling?
Half as good as I look.
Any point in asking for an explanation?
Not much, no.
All right, then the three of you will go to solitary for 24 hours. I'll process the charges myself and you'll all face the VJ.
Can't do that.
I have no option.
What about Jeff's parole?
It's not going to help him, that's obvious. Bit late to think of that now.
Wait. Look, you know me, Mrs. Reynolds. You know I've never lagged in my life. Jeff deserves his parole, and I'm not going to see him lose it.
Myra, no!
Frank ambushed me in the library. If it wasn't for Jeff, I'd be dead.
You rotten lagging bitch! I should have finished you off first! I'll get you, Desmond! You and your boyfriend! Yeah. Next time I'll do it right, I promise you! You hear me? You lagging bitch!
I'm telling you, we had to practically carry him down to the security gates. You're lucky, Marlene, that Matt wasn't there. I'd hate to see a bridegroom with a busted nose.
Well, it's no worse than a bride without a dress. Aww. I don't know, maybe there won't even be a wedding.
God, you're a pain. Why don't you try thinking positive for a change?
All right, I'm positive there won't be a wedding. Look at me, bloody great lump with a head like a box of matches. Some bride.
Look, quit feeling sorry for yourself. We've all got our problems.
Yes, Lexi's right. Myra and Jeff could have been murdered, you know that?
But we weren't. What's this, a wedding or a wake?
Oh, great, I'll be the only bride to have a matron of honour with a shiner.
Oh, well, consider yourself lucky.
So the wedding's back on, is it?
Oh, jeez, I don't know, maybe.
Well, Myra, I have seen the Rainbow Connection, but that is ridiculous.
Yes, everything from puce to pink, eh?
Is Jeff okay?
Yeah, he'll pull through, so will Burke, unfortunately.
Oh, yeah, that bastard.
Kelly's a real mess. She looked about ready to flake out.
Nothing to what she's going to look like when I'm finished with her.
Oh, you're not going to stand on her, eh? The wedding's tomorrow.
Come on, love. Nothing is going to spoil that wedding.
Well, I just hope Jeff gets out of hospital in time.